Hi, this is Ray Horner for Horner's Corner, and today we're at King Community Learning Center, and we're going to sit into the classroom with the Akron Public Schools Teacher of the Year, Jill Finegan. We're going to talk to the students, go into the classroom, and hear from her this week on Horner's Corner.
I would say my style is pretty firm but loving. I really try to have a good command of the classroom control so that everybody can learn. And I really try to make the learning more fun and exciting, and I put it in their terms. And a lot of times I'll act like I don't know the answer and see if they can catch me making a mistake. Or I'll say, oh, I really don't know how to do this problem. I guess I need somebody to show me how to do it. And they think they're, you know, they think that's pretty cool that they're going to teach the teacher. So I don't just stand and deliver. I involve them in their learning.
Medals won at the 1998 Winter Olympics. Each circle stands for how many gold medals?
One.
So what are you going to count by?
One.
Okay, and then what's the next thing we do? Before we move on, what do we do to each little medal? We count them and what?
Put the number.
So Japan had how many gold medals?
Five.
Okay, keep
every
going.
Day, when we feel bad and blue, she tells us what's wrong. She talks to us. She makes us feel better from any situation. She tells us never give up, always try again. Be nice, be kind, have fun, live life. Just have fun.
Because I like her because she teaches us a bunch of cool tricks about learning.
I struggled in math in school. I had a really hard time all the way through college. So I don't want them to struggle. So I keep telling them, if you have little techniques and ways you can learn in third grade, when you hit fourth grade, it's going to be easier, fifth grade, and so on. So I try really hard to bring in my side and how I struggle, because I think they think sometimes teachers, you know, they're like, you know all the answers. I'm like, no, I don't. I'm not even close. So, and I like it when they catch me making a mistake, because that means I have their attention.
Say what? Pictograph. And what's the first thing you look at every time? Until
the key.
The key. And what do we do with the key?
Helps us with like reading, like she, like we do games that involve learning, like with all of these up here, like idioms and stuff.
It's about math and reading, and when we subtract across zeros, she helps us with tricks and different things.
She's a good teacher. She helps us with all the math things and helps us with our math problems and reading and everything like that.
All right. So we're just going to go through math here. Okay, so today we're going to do reading a what kind of graph?
Pictographs and bar graphs.
So what's the clue for pictographs?
I think it always comes down to the kids. It's all about them. Every year it's a new crop, as we say. And I never want to know what I'm getting. I just want to experience the kids, each one at their own individual level. We get kids that come in, have a really big chip on their shoulder, maybe they didn't have a good year. I try to turn that around, and I think that's my challenge. I always want the kid who has, I don't like school. My goal is by the end of the year, like, oh, I don't want to leave school, you know, I don't want to leave you. And I'm like, you'll be fine, go on, now you're good, you know. So.
I wish you had a message.